Welcome to the class on Editorial Decode, and in this class I will be decoding Living in Denial on Kashmir, written by Happy Mom Jacob. Now, from examination point of view, this will help you in General Studies Mains Examination Paper 2. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to understand first of all the nature of Kashmir problem. This is the first thing that we need to understand, and how this nature has undergone change. Secondly, we need to understand about the old Kashmir issue and the new challenges. New Kashmir issue means new challenges, the old challenges. And the third, what needs to be done? What needs to be done? Now, at the face, prima facie, Kashmir problem just looks to be linear problem. At the face, it just looks to be a problem of diplomacy between India and Pakistan. But in reality, when we delve deep into this problem, we find that the problem is very intricate. The problem is very complex. And it is getting inextricable day by day. The complexity to the problem is increasing at a phenomenal pace. Now, Kashmir problem is not a linear problem, it is a polynomial problem. And in order to understand this polynomiality, we need to understand what were the old challenges and what are the new challenges. Now, when it comes to the old challenge, the foremost challenge was the challenge of infiltration. This was the challenge. And the second challenge was the challenge of religion. The incompatibility between the Muslims and the Hindus in Kashmir. I'm just talking about Kashmir, I'm not talking about Jammu and Kashmir, because Kashmir is the main area in which the problem gets intensified time and again. So these two issues were the old issues plus the issue of support for terrorism, local support. Now, we need to know about when did this old challenge transformed into a new challenge. Because here I'm talking about that the Kashmir, it has undergone a kind of a transition in terms of the problems it is facing, the old problems and the new problems. Now, when I'm talking about the term new, the boundary between the old and the new can be distinguished around 2010. Because 2010 was a period of big change in which the support from the local populace has again begun to entrench in Srinagar, in Kashmir region. Before 2010, from 1980s onwards, there was a kind of wane in the support that was provided by the local population. But in 2010, because of the military, fake military encounter that was done by the army, after that, the problem has taken up an upward swing. There has been a lot of support from the local people. Now, when I'm talking about the new thing, you know, what is new in the Srinagar? The first thing that is very new is the support of the ISIAS. Now, when you go to Srinagar, after the Friday prayers, there's a lot of support from the local population for this ISIAS. The flags are waved, and the police is not able to take any action against the people who are just supporting this ISIAS. And secondly, the cross-border support, it has got more intensified. And thirdly, the new thing that I really want to focus here is about the problem of religion. After coming in of the BJP dispensation, after the Lok Sabha elections. The incompatibility, though was in existence before also, but this incompatibility has become more intense. Now, why it has become more intense? Now, when you read the manifesto of the BJP party, you get to know about Uniform Civil Code. This is one thing. And the second thing is about the revocation of Article 370. Now, both these issues, they're very close to the Kashmir population. And then the instances like the Muzaffarpur riots, and after that the riots taking place in other parts of the countries involving the Muslims and the Hindus, the rising fundamentalism in India. India is actually trying to refine itself by focusing more on the Hindutva aspect. This has disillusioned the youth of Kashmir. And after that, the floods in 2013 and 14, those floods have wrecked the soul and the mind of the people in Kashmir. Though a very large package was offered to Kashmir, but very less has been done by that package. That package has proven to be a bust of corruption. So the new challenge that is existing in Kashmir, it is a very intricate challenge, and how we can solve this challenge. Now this situation is becoming more and more complex. So Kashmir is about, now the Kashmir issue is about Uniform Civil Code. The Kashmir issue is about 370. The Kashmir issue is about insurgency. The Kashmir issue is about corruption and administration. Kashmir issue is about the infiltration. The Kashmir issue is about the support from the cross border. So it is a kind of intricate, very complex problem. And we can solve this problem if we will act in a multi-pronged manner. And how can that be done? First of all, the government must assuage. The government must address the issues of the population, that nothing will be done without their consensus with respect to the Uniform Civil Code, with respect to 370, with respect to rising fundamentalism. The government must bring itself close to the bottoms of the hierarchy if it wants to garner the real support of the people. If that will not happen, the crisis is spiraling and it will touch the sky very soon. And the situation may not be very far on the horizon when the Kashmir will be detached from India, might not be very far. I might be sounding like exaggerating, but this is not an exaggeration. This is something that is written on the wall. If the things will be done with the hard policy, with the hard diplomacy, with the enforcing of the Armed Forces Special Power Act, we will not be able to engage the Kashmiri population. Now, if we want to win the heart, we need to mellow down our spa. But right now the situation is not very fine in order to remove this, because of the impending challenge of ISIS, because of the challenge from the cross border. This was supposed to be done in the aftermath of the 2010 crisis in Kashmir, in Srinagar. Then the situation was ripe. By revocating this ASPA in 2010, government could have won over the hearts of the Kashmiri population. So this was all for the editorial decode. Subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. Now, in order to avail the information of the classes, please visit my website brainyias.com. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.